Hey there, and welcome to Play Noggin. I'm Julian, your brain's player too. Prolific game developer Hideo Kojima has been entertaining us with the incredible and insane Metal Gear series for decades now, pushing the limits of what each hardware generation can handle, as well as testing the bladder of any gamer 20 minutes into an hour-long cutscene. The Metal Gear series really took off with the release of the first Metal Gear Solid for the PlayStation back in 1998. With the release of Metal Gear Solid V: The Phantom Pain in 2016, Kojima put an exclamation point on a series that he's poured so much energy into over the years. Even though the game is a prequel and takes place in the 80s, a lot of the technology looks modern or even futuristic. How much of that tech is real, and how much of it was cooked up in a Kojima fever dream? Well, let's take a look. When talking about MGSV: The Phantom Pain, there's only one obvious place to start. That's right, prosthetic limbs. We've been using prosthetic limbs for a really long time. So long, in fact, that if an ancient Egyptian had a pyramid brick dropped on his toe, he could have gotten a replacement made out of wood. Fortunately, we've come a long way since wooden toe technology. In MGS5, the main character, Big Boss, has a prosthetic arm that is, to borrow an 80s term, pretty rad. Not only can he use it like a real arm, but it can detect bad guys with sonar, stun them with a shock, and even fire itself off as a rocket to punch some morale into hapless soldiers around Mother Base. While rocket, sonar, electro hands still don't exist today, sadly, bionic hands are slowly becoming a reality. When people lose a limb, their brain doesn't just forget about it and move on. They can still have the sensation that their arm or leg is there as a so-called phantom limb, and can even feel phantom pain in a body part they no longer have. You may have noticed Big Boss keeps bringing it up throughout the game. Sounds like adding insult to injury, but there's actually a silver lining. Because the brain of an amputee is still wired as though the limb is there, advanced prosthetics can be controlled with thought alone. Newer prosthetics use electrodes positioned on muscles to intercept electrical impulses from the brain and translate them to movement in mechanical appendages. Then all the wearer has to do is think, open, and their sweet robo hand will open. Okay, it's not quite that simple. It takes hours and hours of practice just to get simple tasks down, but steadily, you and your new limb will become much more fluid. Enough to knock a guy out with some close quarters combat? Probably not. But if you meet a quarter cyborg crawling around in a box, it's probably best not to find out. Just let him shuffle on his way. Of course, if you do make the mistake of checking under that box, then there's a decent chance you're just going to get a balloon ride. Metal Gear Solid V introduced us to the Fulton Recovery System, which allows you to prank bears by launching them into the sky. Amazingly, this is a piece of mostly real technology. The Fulton Surface-to-Air Recovery System, more catchily known as the Skyhook, was created in the 1950s by inventor Robert Fulton. Before him, something similar did exist, only instead of balloons, it used two poles stuck in the ground on either side of a target with a line running between them, which a passing rescue plane would hook. The system was used to pick up bags of mail on the fly, but for living things like people or sheep, it wasn't ideal. First, there's the problem of sudden acceleration. Early systems had some give in the line, but the sudden yank was still dangerous and even killed a sheep in testing. And because the yank is lateral, you better hope there are no big trees or rocks in your path when you call for your Sky Uber. Robert Fulton solved all these problems with a balloon. The balloon didn't hoist the package itself into the air because that's not really possible. A balloon like those used in Metal Gear definitely wouldn't have the buoyancy to lift a person, let alone catapult them into the sky, even using helium, the second lightest element. And yes, we know it's not the first lightest element, hydrogen, because hydrogen is flammable, and if you shot the balloon, all you'd end up with is a very charred and unextracted soldier. Fulton's balloon lifted a 500-foot line into the air instead, with the package or person attached to the ground. Then a plane with a special V-shaped nose hook would snag the line and release the balloon. Because of the long line, it would curve, meaning even though the plane was carrying one end laterally, the other end attached to the soldier would go straight up at first. Then he would gradually accelerate as the line straightened out and trailed behind the plane. Finally, he would be winched into the bottom of the plane, where it was less windy. This system made quick extraction possible, even from dense forests, and was used regularly by the CIA. Alright, it's time for the moment you've all been waiting for. The Metal Gears themselves. We've seen enough world news to know that giant mechs haven't taken over the battlefield, but that's not to say we haven't been working on the technology to make it possible. In Metal Gear Solid V, Big Boss battles a giant, walking, humanoid mech called Sahelanthropus, named for the skull of an ancient human ancestor. Sahelanthropus was a stepping stone from crouched-over, knuckle-walking, ape-like ancestors to upright-walking humans, and this Metal Gear is the first to walk upright on two legs all the time. You get the feeling Hideo Kojima is a massive nerd? We didn't really have the sort of tech necessary to make sophisticated bipedal giant robots in the 80s, but we've doggedly continued developing the elements of our own fiery destruction. In the 1960s, General Electric developed something colloquially known as the walking truck, but more sinisterly known as the cybernetic anthropomorphous machine, which mimics the movements of its pilot. Think Ripley in Aliens, but four-legged and dorkier. More recently, in 2004, Japan developed what is known as the Hyper Rescue Robot to aid in rescue operations after earthquakes. And by aid in rescue, I mean tossing cars out of the way with its giant metal arms. And of course, battlefield robots have been a goal for the military for some time, but the ones that exist today are more remote-controlled mini-tanks and flying death drones than giant nuclear-equipped megazords. So there's no Metal Gears yet, or in the 80s, or in the near future, but Hideo Kojima can dream. Hey, thanks for watching. As usual, if you like what you saw, please like and subscribe. Check out some of our other videos here, like our more in-depth look at bipedal robots from Titanfall 2. And if you have an idea for a game you'd like to see us cover, drop it in a comment below. Don't forget to keep on playing.